Quenby Go of Manila Angel Investors Network. Hi, Quenby. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, Mimi. Thank you for having me.
All right. So in general, why don't you characterize for us the Philippine startup ecosystem today?
It has been said that the Philippine startup ecosystem is still at its infancy stage. Mm-hmm. But recently, we've seen more favorable demographic and economic indicators, which I think is a healthy environment for startups right now. The last few years, we've seen emergence of angel investors, venture capitalist groups. That means that there's a strong foundation for growth. In 2021 alone, there's about over $1 billion invested in Philippine startups. This is not just from the Philippines, but you know, international and our regional investors are taking notice. Even our deal flow, or the number of startups that have been invested in, has grown from 2019 to 2020 and 2021, mostly in the fintech sector, the media and entertainment sector. There are other sectors like health tech, food tech, e-commerce. You know, everything has been, all these sectors have been growing, which is contributing to a very healthy ecosystem. In 2022 alone, the first 2 months, we've already invested, there's already been an investment of $310 million into the Philippine ecosystem, mostly in fintech. A sample would be Grocery, who raised their Series C round already. They've grown it to $45 million. And then there's also PayMongo that's done with their Series B round at $31 million. Our rating has been growing around the, you know, globally, like out of 1,000 global cities, the Philippines is ranked 87, next to Sacramento, USA, which is at 86. And then also our in Asia Pacific, we are also out of 20, we are ranked the 20th, next to China, which is the 19th. And then the startup ecosystem ranking, we've grown inch by inch since 2019. We're now at 52 as compared to 54 before. FinTech remains to be the industry that startups have been growing and investors been most interested in lately.
And Quenby, are there more? I'm very curious. Are there more investors than there are startups to fund, or is it the other way around? And would you say that, you know, local investors are becoming more liberal? You did cite big amounts, like $1 billion investments done recently. How much of that would you say came from local money, and how much from international funds?
Okay, for your first question, more startups than investors, or the other way around? So in 2020, there were only about, based on Foxmont's report, there were only 400 startups, about 50 angel investors at that time, and about 40 venture capitalists, and 35 incubators and accelerators. In last year, there are already roughly about 1,000 startups, wow. 40 venture capitalists, 35 incubators, 35 incubators and accelerators. So there are more startups than investors right now here in the Philippines.
All right, and when it comes to the money being poured into these startups, is it 50-50, local and foreign?
Right now, there is a growing amount of, we're getting a lot of foreign recognition. Silicon Valley has been taking notice of us. Y Combinator has already invested in 5 Philippine companies, one of which is what the Philippines invested in, which is, Maine invested in, which is called Mad Eats, which is a food tech. So I don't have the exact number of the balance of the investors, but it is a growing industry right now because a lot of people have been diversifying their portfolio. Mm-hmm. They want to not only invest in the traditional instruments, but startups is one thing that they feel is a good way to invest money right now.
And even the big conglomerates here in the Philippines are getting in on the game as well. Very quickly, you belong to a pretty big group, Manila Angel Investors Network. It's a network of angel investors. Who is currently the most active angel investor in the Philippines?
There are several. I wouldn't say there's just one, but of course, the more popular names you would know would be the Gokongways, the Lairs, the Ayalas through 917 Ventures, the Seas, of course. Then you have other players who are investment corporations like AIB, Amalgamated Investment Corporation. You have Gobi Partners, XPH. It varies because you have angel investors that invest in pre-seed, seed, and Series A rounds like Maine. Then you have the VCs like Foxmont, companies that would go to Series B funding round, Series C funding round.
And Quinby, final question very quickly because we don't have much time. Are you seeing, you know, less Me Too startups and more innovative, game-changing startups today? I mean, what's the most innovative, creative startup you've come across? The most promising one that stands out for you right now?
Okay, so of course in the Philippines, Kumu is one of those that are signing out. We're already identifying it as our first Philippine unicorn. Rexy Dorado actually coined a place in Poblacion now called Sinigang Valley, which is trying to liken it to the Silicon Valley of San Francisco. A lot of our incubators, accelerators, startups, investors are located there right now because we want to form a community that will nurture and entrepreneurs and help them thrive.
Right.
So saying that again, are there a lot of Me Too movements right now? You know, yes. There are a lot of organizations, let's say like the AVPN, Gobi Partners, they really want to invest in female founders, Philippine startups that are supporting Filipino communities, women Filipino communities, and women in their C-suite. We're trying to disrupt biases that women cannot handle startups that are fundamental and that can make money. But we can see during the pandemic, a lot of female startups started to come out. They not only, since they don't have to travel, they can actually take care of business as well as take care of family matters. So the Philippines, Maine actually got a grant from the Australian government through Investing with Women, which helps Maine operate and do initiatives regarding gender-led investment.
All right. Thank you very much, Quinby, for joining us today, and good luck. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mimi.
All right. And